thank you for coming, everybody. I'm Ken Kroll. I'm the police chief. I'm the police chief because of many people who are here and many people who are named here today. Thank you very much. I'd like to thank Mayor Noak and the Village of Romeoville trustees for blessing this project. Especially like to thank John Allen, White Architecture, and Dawn Caudwell for making this happen. Several weeks ago, I was leaving Village Hall, and it was 8 or 9 o'clock at night. I was on my way from Village Hall through this corridor here, and after one of the Fire and Police Commission meetings, it was raining out, and I saw the memorial lit for the first time, and it had the sprinkle of rain droplets on it, and it was magnificent. It was absolutely impressive. I went in and told the night guys, I'm like, oh my God, it looks great. They're like, it's the first time you're seeing it? You should be here at night more often. So today, I'm reminded of what a great facility we have and what tremendous support we get from the village and from all of you. Thank you very much. Lastly, I'd like to point out that several of my police heroes are named here. Several of them are here. And every single day I carry Dwayne Chambers' firearm with me. Thank you. I'm going to turn it over to Chaplain Hudson for an opening prayer.
Can we bow our heads? Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for another opportunity to come and give you praise, glory, and honor. Lord, we just come to celebrate the lives of those who had the honor to wear the Romeoville Police Department badge. Lord, we thank you for their service. We thank you for their sacrifice. Lord, we thank you for their bravery, their honor, their integrity, their honesty. Lord, we thank you, Lord, that they are a great police department. Lord, that they are an example, Father, to other police departments, Lord. I thank you right now, Lord, that we feel safe at night because they are on the streets. Lord, we pray right now, Lord, that you continue to bless them, that you continue to keep them. Lord, we pray over the government right now, Lord. We pray over our mayor right now, Lord, the chief of police, Lord, that you keep them in your care right now, Lord. Give them the wisdom that is needed to continue to lead this city the way you choose for it to be led. So, Father, we thank you right now. We're here to celebrate the lives of those who have passed on and celebrate those who are still here giving us service. So, Lord, we thank you for the police department, Lord. We thank you for this village. We thank you for the government. We thank you for those who are here to celebrate right now. We thank you for those families, Lord, who pray and give us their husbands and their wives to serve us. So, Lord, we thank you today, and it's in your Son Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Yeah, I want to begin by thanking everybody that's here today. You know, we've certainly got some challenging times right now, and that makes events like this even more important. While we have to be creative in the way that we put them on, it is so vitally important that we continue to move forward and recognize the service of individuals to our community. You know, we've seen them do things and rise above so much over the last few months. You know, and it's really a key reminder of the types of dedication that the men and women in the K-9 units have given over the years. There's many others that have also risen up, but this is a special occasion to keep moving forward and recognize those who have done so much over the years and that have unfortunately left us now. But we want to remember that legacy, remember all the commitment they've made over that time. And, you know, on behalf of the entire village board and our entire community, express our gratitude for generations to come for that service. And, you know, hopefully this will be a place to reflect, to come, to remember that service, you know, and remember fondly the things that they did that allowed us to be here today. You know, if not for the hard work of the individuals that are recognized here and those that also throughout our community, we wouldn't be able to have an event like this today. And so let's remember that the things they've done for us and how that continues, that their legacy continues to be a foundation which we build on for years to come. And so, you know, I'm very proud that we've been able to, as a community, move forward on this project. I'm glad that we can be here together to gather to dedicate this memorial for our officers and our canines and come together and reflect on them and those who are continuing to work for us, because they're so vitally important to our community and are parts of our greater family. So please, and check out the memorial. And for the community that isn't be able to be a part of this today, I very much encourage you to come and be a part of this and learn about those who have served our community and why we were able to do the things we are able to do and what they meant to us, what they meant to the families that are here, what they continue to mean to us, because their memories are here. And they're with these families, and they're with everything that we do. And so please come and reflect on that. I especially encourage you, the public, to come be a part of this also throughout the evening. It's a beautiful sight. It's designed that you can come out throughout the evening, and it's illuminated, and it's right here in the central part of our Village Hall and Police Complexes, so that everyone being a part of this day in and day out can remember these individuals and the things that the dedication that they had for our community and be a part of that. So I'm just proud to be a part of it today, to be here with you and to remember those that have served us and continue to be a part of us. So thank you. And I'm gonna turn it over now.
Thank you. I'd like to thank the mayor, the village trustees, the village manager for making this memorial possible. I also think we need to thank John Allen, who is retired, and was our previous K-9 officer, who started the seed to get the memorial going. From 1996 until 2005, I was honored to serve as the K-9 officer for the village of Romeoville. I remember going to Von Lick Kennels and finding my partner, Rocco. Rocco was a one-year-old Dutch Shepherd. During my 6 weeks of K-9 school, I learned the special bond between Rocco and myself. Besides Rocco being a police officer, he also became part of the family. When I first brought him home, my wife Tina was a little apprehensive, but after 14 years of living with us, Rocco became part of the family. During our 9-year career, Rocco in 2001 located in a semi-truck in Bolingbrook 14,000 pounds of marijuana. In 2005, Rocco finally retired and then became the family dog. Rocco at first had a difficult time when I would get ready for work and leave without him. But then he found two new handlers at home with Tina and our daughter, Angela. In closing, my daughter wrote a poem in reference to canines and their handlers, so I'll just read it. Sing with the sirens, partnership, captured in a single image, my life placed within your paw, our duty to uphold the law, your gentle eyes guided us through darkness, alert ears listened for danger, keen nose determined to make our streets safer. You never missed a beat, eager dancing tail, howling to the song of sirens, red, white, and blue, everyone loved you. Kind soul, fierce protector, unbreakable bond, canine and handler. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Pastor Suzanne. I've had the privilege of serving the police department here in Romeoville for 20 years. And I've watched this memorial develop, and it's a great opportunity for our village, as the mayor said, to come and see. Part of my heart is on that wall there, our dear friend Sandy Dreher. And so it's really nice to be able to come and just see it and know all the good memories. So earlier today I had a memorial service and I shared this quote, and I decided I wanted to share it for the closing today. It's by Leo Biscaglia, who was a Italian speaker, professor. He talked a lot about love. That's what he's most known for. And I know there are some family members here of some of our officers who are on the memorial. And I guess this is for all of you and for anyone who's lost loved ones. We remember their laughter, and believe me, I've been around a lot of laughter in this police department over the years, some of it a little goofy, but nonetheless, that's what gets us through. And I've shared a lot of tears as well. And so most of all, it's love. And this is what I want to leave you with. I know for certain that we never lose the people we love, even to death. They continue to participate in every act, thought, and decision we make. Their love leaves an indelible imprint in our memories. We find comfort in knowing that our lives have been enriched by having shared their love. Let us pray. God, we thank you. We thank you for the love that we have for one another, and especially for our families of those who are now a part of this police memorial. We thank you that in our lives we carry their legacy, the legacy of service and honesty, and most of all, integrity. Bless those families who are here today and those who are not able to be here. As they come and walk among these names, help them to feel pride, to be thankful for the lives that their loved ones lived. God, we thank you for the officers who serve today and always for their families. We thank you for the time that they lose with their loved one who is serving. Just strengthen our community as we learn to support each other and love each other. And may all that we have honor and glorify you. And we pray this in your name. Amen.
Thank you so much. We also, before we conclude, want to let the individual that purchased or have bricks that we need to disseminate, that we have those available. I believe we are going to be doing that just inside for those who have bricks to come. And again, I want to just conclude the program once again, reminding not only the people here, but again, the people throughout our community, that these individuals were family members, they were employees, they were workers, they were officers, they were everything to a lot of different people. And the reality is that their legacy is in all of us. And let's try and remember that each and every day, not just here, but in everything we do. And I hope that their spirit continues to live through all of us forever. Thank you. And that'll conclude our program.